Today, Karina and Eric have chosen to share their love before all of us and to celebrate their new life together. The ability and desire for one human being to love another is the most precious and fulfilling gift that has been entrusted upon us. It is an all-consuming task, a lifelong endeavor, and a journey that we prepare for our whole lives. To love someone fully means to stretch beyond our limits and to become more for the sake of the other. Marriage is the ultimate commitment, which challenges us to become who we're meant to be.
About how I met Karina. I was planning the trip just about a month or two after Eric and Karina met, so I asked if he wanted to ask her to come along with us. When he finally got back to me, Eric is a notoriously slow text responder, so 3 or 4 days, maybe 5 days later, he said she wanted to come. And I thought to myself, uh-oh. Not at all because I didn't like her. I hadn't met her yet, but because the 10 of us could be a bit much to handle all at once, and I've never had anyone willingly leave the ski trip early before. So I was hoping that wasn't a first. In fact, it was a few years later on another ski trip when Eric proposed to Karina. He had told me ahead of time that it was going to happen, but he didn't exactly have all the details hammered out. We took a non-ski day to Napa Valley, and got to our last winery stop. Mind you, Eric knew this was the last stop because of my spreadsheet. Okay, it's go time. Okay. He grabs Karina and beelines toward the winery before half the group even had a chance to get out of the car. I was supposed to be the one taking pictures and I was stuck in the back. So I wormed my way out and started running after them with my phone. Karina, just as she was probably about to ask him why she was entered into this speed walking contest she didn't sign up for, stop, they turned around on a bridge, and Eric got down on one knee and proposed to Karina right there at the winery. Karina, it's great to have you as part of our family now, and I think you bring out the best in Eric. I'll even give you credit with breaking some of his stubborn mule tendencies that none of us were able to ever do. And lastly, I know Eric and Karina were so disappointed to not have each of you here with them last year, and I can only imagine what a disappointment it was for them to have to postpone and reschedule this at that time. So I'm asking that each of you celebrate with them twice as hard tonight to make up for it. So let's raise a glass, say cheers.
Yes, so we met on a blind date 5 years ago, coming up on 5 years in December. And I guess, like they say, the rest is history. We kind of hit it off the first date and then went on another one and another one. Now we're getting married again. And it's been so much fun. I'd marry her every year for the rest of my life if I could.
So we met on a blind date that I didn't want to go on. I was excited to just live by myself for the rest of my life in solidarity. And we just kind of hit it off. because he's nerdy and I'm nerdy and we're goofy and we're very sarcastic and have very dry personalities, and it just worked. And here we are, two weddings later. He's very, very sweet. He bought me flowers for the first time in 4 years for my birthday this year. He's just very thoughtful. He always puts you first, all above himself. He's thoughtless, and I honestly could not have married a better person.
And yeah, I think, you know, just the past 5 years, if, you know, that's any taste of what the rest of my life's gonna be like, I'm really excited that I found her, and I'm really excited that we get to just kind of have this life for forever. I love you, and I'm excited for today.
Well, Boo Boo, you are literally my favorite person in the entire universe, and I honestly couldn't imagine my life without you, and I hope we have very many years together, because I love you so, so much. I don't want to cry, so I'm done.
It is hard to believe after 2.5 years that we are here. It seems like just yesterday I was in Old Forge washing Karina in her hard-headed nature, play in the dirt and get muddy, and then become a young lady dancing, as Jason said, up to the point where my favorite memory was as a senior in high school, walking around the school with the superintendent and one of our congressmen. We walked to the band room, and all of a sudden Karina was doing aerials, and I said, yes, that's my daughter. But the OCD hard-headedness has prevailed forever, and she's turned it into a great career and has bailed my butt out on numerous occasions, personally from a business point of view, with those skills. But she's a wonderful person, and she's, you might be, Eric, I've got a new appreciation for your middle name, but I think you've been outdone at this juncture in time. But, you know, she's turned into a beautiful, wonderful young lady, and Eric, I couldn't ask for a better son-in-law to help be the yin to her yang, because God knows at times she needs to be calmed down.
It's been said by many people, a marriage is when two become one. The problem occurs when we can't decide which one. My hope for Eric and Karina is that they never have to make that decision. So, Eric and Karina.
Happiness in marriage is not something that just happens. A good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It's never going to sleep angry. It's to have a mutual sense and values of common objectives. It is standing together to face the world. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family.
Hi, dear. You look nice. It's okay to kiss.
We're already married. It's okay.
Okay.
At this time, Karina and Eric, please take each other's hands. The formal exchange of your wedding vows is the most sacred part of the wedding ceremony. As you speak them to one another, you will discover that these are truly sacred promises, and sacred promises must be kept forever. As I speak these words to you now, I ask for you to speak them to each other, and these are the vows that Eric and Karina have chosen.
Thank you.
I vow to need you as long as the seasons need to follow their plan.
I vow to need you as long as the seasons need to follow their plan.
I vow to be with you as long as the sea is bound to wash up on the sand.
I vow to be with you as long as
keep going.
The sea is bound to wash up on the sand.
Okay.
I vow to want you as long as you want me and longer by far.
I vow to want you as long as you want me and longer by far.
I vow to give to you as long as I live through you, however long you say.
I vow to give to you as long as I forget.
Now you can read it. Okay. As long I live through you, here, however long you say.
Yeah, that.
That.
Okay. I vow to need you.
I vow to need you.
As long as the seasons need.
As long as the seasons need.
To follow their
to
plan.
To follow their plan.
I vow to be with you.
I vow to be with you.
As long as the sea is bound.
As long as the sea is bound to wash up on the sands.
Well, you got that one. You're done. You're good.
Hey, yeah.
I vow to want you.
I vow to want you.
As long as you want me.
As long as you want me to and longer by far.
We know who wrote the vows, y'all.
Ellie Goulding did, yeah. It's fine.
I vow to love you.
I vow to love you.
As long as the stars are above you.
As long as the stars are above you.
And longer if I may.
Longer if I may.
I, Eric, take you, Karina, to be my wife, promise to love you, honor you, and respect you, to be faithful to you, and to forsake all others till death do us part.
I, Karina, take you, Eric, to be my husband, promise to love you, honor you, and respect you, to be faithful for you and forsake all others until death do us part.
Karina and Eric, you have expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promises you have just made. It is with these in mind I pronounce you husband and wife again. No longer simple partners and best friends, you have become husband and wife.
Again.
And now we seal the agreement with a kiss. But today, your kiss is a promise. A promise to be in love and keep each other forever. You may now kiss your bride.
I will.
I'm gonna give you a quick four-pointers if you didn't know, or if you don't know Karina. Don't wake her up before 9, no matter how much you want a breakfast sandwich. Doesn't work. Don't leave the TV or the radio on odd numbers unless it's divisible by 5. Karina, that ends in 5 and zeros for you. Make sure to keep neat and tidy. Good news, I found out earlier this week, Eric passed his 2-month or little class there, and Karina gave you approval grade, so you're good. Make sure to keep her well fed. The hangry is a problem. Hangry is a problem. Right? The good news is, now Eric's giving me advice. Like when I come over, what dish towel to use. One for the hands, one for the towels, one for the counter, one for the dishes, a lot. Don't use the wrong one. Not gonna end well for you. No. Seriously, best part, how happy you make Karina. I couldn't have asked for a better brother and someone to continually to make the person I love most in this life. Karina, I wanna leave you with some warm words from one of our favorite songs, because I assume it's not on the DJ's approved list. Sister, I hear you laugh, my heart feels full of love. Sister, when you cry, I feel your tears running down my face. Sister, sister, keep me. Karina, love you more than anything in this world. Eric, thank you so much.